It's like I'm missing some piece of this puzzle that is required as a Puff player. It's like there needs to be a rule, like some kind of Ten Commandments of Puff that I can refer to and follow. Because in Melee, when I lost in Melee, me and Crunch were able to figure out exactly why I lost. We were able to figure out exactly what I was missing and exactly what works in the matchups. I wish I had that rulebook here. I wish I had some way to know exactly what I'm doing wrong. Can Puff really do it? She got some buffs, right? Nintendo, no one has the source code for Ultimate, but Nintendo put in lots of little interesting numbers into the game. It's the tease, right? Fuck, how do I put, I know I'm ranting right now, but it's the tease, right? Nintendo put in a drill rest for Puff. When you hit it, you can guarantee a rest on the whole cast. But it's by chance. It's just
almost 1 year.
Why would they give me just that? It's just like the faintest hope. Like right now, I'm in the sunken place. And I'm looking up and there's this tiny, I'm telling you, the littlest, tiniest gliver of light that says, this is how you win, always the Puff. It's so small, but it's right there. And Ultimate's a much more balanced game than Melee, right? But Puff is a lot worse, obviously. But it begs the question, if you become that good, if you become this monster in neutral who wins twice as many interactions as any other person, can she do it? Is it worth it to go to the extra level of insanity? Like right now, you're watching, what the reason you guys sub and the reason we have over 1,000 viewers or even over 2K viewers on my stream is because you're watching an Argentinian bearded slot machine at his job. That's all this is. It's a slot machine, and when we hit triple sevens, we fucking lose our minds because the hype is shit possible. But right now, I don't want a slot machine. I don't want to play bingo. I want a fucking arm wrestle where the better player always wins. But how do you turn a slot arm into an actual arm? That's what I'm trying to figure out. I know I see a lot of the chat saying you need to play another character, you gotta pick up his top tier. If I wanted to use a top tier and be the best player in the world, I would just stream Melee every fucking day. It's something that I've done and I'm very proud of, and I know I can do it. This is a more unique challenge for me. This is a different thing. This is a new animal, and I want to do it in Ultimate. I want to do it in Ultimate with Puff. It's different. It's just like, I've lived the life playing a great character and being the top dog and doing it, alright? Do you understand what I mean? I've felt the trophies. I've felt what it feels like to hold an Evo trophy in your hand. What I still haven't felt is to have the entire stadium. I mean, every single fucking person in the stadium roaring for you. Even if they're not there for you, if they're there for someone else, but watching you win is something beyond a dub. It's beyond fandoms. It's something impossible that has never been done. That's what I fucking want to do. I wasn't even the first Puff to be the best in the world. Mango did it with Puff, switched, obviously, then I did it, and I pushed it further, obviously. But I want to do something no one's ever done. Do you know how insane that would be? And her being that shitty makes it that special for me. That's what I'm saying. And we have these little tidbits of hope where it's right there. It's right there in front of me and it's tangible. Where I'm one drill rest away from beating Best Nest Online. Where I'm taking games off MKLeo's Joker. Where I can three-stock Nairo or Meister when I happen to hit the odds. You know what I mean? Like, why is that hope there? I wish it was just more of a thing where it's like, it can't be done. I wish... If Nairo and MKLeo would 3-stock me over and over again, I'd be like, okay, now I know it's actually 0%. But to have the reality, to know that it's actually there, that it's doable, that's what fucks with me. Puff isn't like Ganondorf. Like, Puff is, she has a clutch option. She has a lever that if you pull at the right time, it beats everyone. It's just so hard to connect. In Melee, I loved the game, but I was the most competitive kid on my fucking block. Me and Crunch would play until 6 in the morning, multiple times a week, because we just had to be the best at it, right? And we noticed that when I went to tournaments, I could beat a lot of people there with Puff. In fact, eventually I started winning locals. And I, without proper coaching, just purely grinding and playing all the matchups that I could. I got really good at the game with Puff, and I just grinded it, right? And then I didn't realize Puff was like a character that could win national tournaments, but it just happened. I just chose the right character at the right time, and it was there. The issue is, I'm not there right now in obviously in Ultimate. I'm nowhere near, you know, top five in the world. When I became top five in the world with no coaching, that's when I finally asked for a coach. Because that's the point where I plateaued. I hit this plateau at top five and I couldn't get past it. And that's what Crunch did for me, because Crunch was a melee mastermind. He's not an ultimate mastermind. So if the answer is a coach, it's fine. But again, should I have a coach? Should I have a coach when I'm not even PGR ranked? It took me 2 years to become pro in melee. I've been really grinding ultimate. If I'm talking about really grinding it, if we're talking about the streams, I've been really grinding ultimate since December, right? Because when Puff got buffed is when I actually started believing again. So right now I've been playing 6 months. In a year and a half, will I be a fucking PGR threat? Maybe. Will it be with Puff? Imagine. But when I ask top players, when I ask the field what I should do, they don't say do this more often. You know, obviously base mage gives me like, you know, Puff advice and tech and counter picks, which is awesome. But top players, the best players in the world, MKLeo, Nairo, Esam, all they say is just switch. Puff sucks. Puff sucks. Puff sucks. Puff sucks. Puff sucks. Puff sucks. That's what I say. And I don't blame them, right? Because if a young melee player who mained Link walked up to me in melee and said, Hbox, I'm trying my best to do good with Link. I'm getting top 16 at my locals with Link sometimes. What do I do? How can I not look this poor kid in the face and say, Link is... melee Link is just ass, right? But then you see Zane with Roy doing some incredible shit. But then you play Link versus Falco and you'll understand exactly what I'm talking about. But Link is not ultimate Puff. Melee Link is not ultimate Puff. A low tier... Puff in Ultimate isn't your traditional low tier by any means, for one reason, and that's rest. A way to kill reliably when you know how to set it up. That's what makes this so just, it's like addicting. It's the fucking, it's like you're hoping for this confirm. You're hoping for this amazing way to actually do the miracle run. You know what I mean? It's insanity. It's like you know you're going down a bad path and playing it. It's like you know you're doing that, but because Puff has that clutch factor, maybe in some universe, in some run of some tournament, when you play enough, maybe eventually you'll get the run of the lifetime. And I'm telling you, chat, if I was to ever win a major with Puff and Ultimate, it would be one of the most legendary runs you've ever seen. The RNG involved, the reads involved, the amount of outplays you would have to do that would be the greatest accomplishment in my entire career. And that's why I want to do it so badly. That's why I want it so badly. Because it would be, my handprint's already on the ceiling. I want to punch the fuck through it. I want to get past the ceiling. Break into the atmosphere. But her matchup spread is so, so hard. But why can't I be the next Rangchu? Why can't I do what no one else has done? This is inspiring. I forgot this happened, you know? I wanted to main an uncommon character that people would be able to play. So he wanted to play a weird character on purpose. Interesting. And he's not good at sidestepping. Okay. I mean, I played Puff in melee because I wasn't very good at tech skill stuff. I can relate. Okay, that's interesting. Oh no!
Be careful, if one more, he can end it here. Q-Dance!
He won with the bear. I want that. I want that with Puff and Ultimate, dude. I am now inspired. I will become the best Tekken player in the world. I'm gonna buy an Xbox right now, or a PS5, whatever it is, and then we're gonna go ahead and do this. And I'm gonna play Devil Jin. Let's get started. Fuck this other game.